Good afternoon, everyone, and Merry Christmas from the West Yorkshire Police Cybercrime Team and the Yorkshire and Humber Regional Cybercrime Team. My name's Vanessa Smith, and I lead both units in tackling cybercrime. Now, obviously, I've opened it up with Merry Christmas because, obviously, it's Christmas the next few weeks, and all those people who are looking to get those last-minute bargains or rush round to those shops, or perhaps not, and do their shopping online, hopefully I can give some hints and tips so that you're not going to be a victim of fraud or theft of your identity. So if I can get straight into it, because I appreciate you've only got a few minutes, and thank you very much for joining us. So the first thing is about your mobile apps. Now, if you've got a telephone or another mobile digital device, just please make sure that when you are actually downloading your apps that perhaps are trying to advertise a particular product, that you download it from, for example, if it's Google, it's going to be from Play Store, or if it's from Apple, it's from their Apple Store. If you make sure that at least that they vet their apps, and it does make sure that they are bona fide when you download them. Nextly, when you're thinking about buying something online, make sure that you do it from a website that you trust. Well, how do I trust that website? Well, perhaps if you've used it before or it's gone on recommendation, that's always a good tip. But also looking at the actual address bar. On the address bar, when it says HTTP, if it says S, that stands for secure. That gives you another tip to make sure that any transactions are secure. And then in the bottom right hand corner, something, you know, where the timing is usually at, there'll be a yellow padlock. That again denotes that it's secure. So just to recap, if you're looking at the top of the search bar and it says HTTP and you're looking for S, that's S for sugar, then that also stands for secure. And the bottom right is that yellow keypad. Now, at this time of year, lots of people get in contact with you, family, friends, asking you what you want to buy themselves or perhaps the children, etc. But that also leads it to fraudsters who are trying to target you via social media. You probably, if you're on maybe Facebook or Twitter or other social media, which there's literally hundreds out of there, you might be getting some pop-ups from people advertising particular products. Now, if those products are a massive discount, like 50% or 40% discount, and you think, oh God, that's too good to be true, well, the phrase is, it ends, it usually is. So again, be very careful that when you're getting pop-ups from your social media, that you actually look at not clicking onto any links, but actually coming out of your Facebook and perhaps looking at them on another secure network, so that you're not using their link to get into their system, and you can perhaps just do some research on it. You might want to get into the cert.gov.uk, which is a government site giving you hints and tips on how to protect yourself, or Get Safe Online, who again gives you hints and tips about safe online shopping. This, you know, these little tips, I hope, I know they might seem obvious, but to some people it doesn't, and it does actually try and protect yourself. When we've looked at the figures from last year, there's been a 67% increase of fraudsters, for example, using Instagram to give promotions, usually on electronic devices and mobile phones, to give you those offers. And what they're trying to do there is to capture your data, because no longer really financial, financially they want your particular money out of your account. A lot of fraudsters now are wanting your particular details, you know, your name, address, your date of birth, even your bank account details, just so that they can sell your details or use your details fraudulently to apply for loans, purchase other products, because your personal details has got longevity beyond the £50 or £100 they've been able to, you know, get from you. So please, when you're buying online, look at the yellow padlock. Make sure there's an S at the top of the screen where it says HTTPS. Never pay by direct payment. Make sure that you go through such a conduit such as PayPal. And just another hint with PayPal. If PayPal, and you bank with a PayPal or do transactions, if PayPal send you a link, which they've done for, to me, and they and tell you to click onto it and then you can get into your account, just make sure that you don't click onto that link, because there are fraudsters out there that use that method to capture your information. So I would suggest you come out of your that particular email and you go actually into PayPal using your legitimate logon details. That way, that's a safe way of you get checking your account or looking for the update that email gives you. So, word of warning now, I've mentioned a couple of times about links. You know, please think before you click, because these links, when they're sent to you from a person who you're not expecting an email from, or indeed from perhaps a shop or a provider that you've never dealt with before, and they're asking you to click onto links, then I would have a degree of caution and suspicion over that, and could never click on the link, come out of it, and perhaps try another means to search for that particular address and get into that website. When we look at, we're all busy, I know that, and when it comes to Christmas time, we all want those last minute bargains. We're rushing round, for example, if it's in Leeds, the White Rose Shopping Centre and other centres, and perhaps, you know, trying to give us half an hour at a coffee shop, or just using that just to look online and trying to get that latest bargain or compare prices. What I'd say to people is, if you are using public Wi-Fi, please never, never do a transfer, a bank transfer or a finance transaction using public Wi-Fi. Public Wi-Fi is that what it says is public, and everybody can actually access that. And there's a degree of less secure and it's more vulnerable. So if you're wanting and you are out and about to use a public Wi-Fi, there is something called a VPN. And that's a virtual network proxy, which allows you, you can download a VPN from an app store, whether it be Apple or it might be Google, and you can then allows you to have a secure connection by using this VPN, a secure VPN. So when you are clicking onto a public Wi-Fi, that gives you a secure connection, like a tunnel, a virtual tunnel between your device and the public Wi-Fi. So no matter, so what transactions are happening between transmitted from your device to the public network is secure. That is something, and you can get good VPNs out there on Apple and Play Store free of charge or for a very limited amount of money. Otherwise, what I would do is use your own private mobile data, because that, by using your own private data storage, that will mean that it's secure as well. So these are just a couple of hints and tips. If you want to know more about VPNs, then again, you've got West Yorkshire Police Cybercrime Team webpage, and we've also got, that's click before you call. We've also got Get Safe Online, cert.gov.uk. So there's all these areas there to look at. And, you know, other tips are very basic. I know I keep repeating this, so apologies for those people who have heard this time and time again. But please just make sure that, you know, your devices, if it asks you for an update, click on the update and make sure it's updated, so your operating system is operating so it's all as fully secure. Every week, usually on a Tuesday, you'll find that Apple and Apple and Microsoft will have looked the previous week of any vulnerabilities within their software, And what they will do is they call it a patch. That means a little bit like a sticking plaster over a particular wound. So what they've done is realise the vulnerability and want you to update their software so that it then your software is not vulnerable to a recognised attack that they've seen. So just make sure that your antivirus is up to date, that your operating systems, if it's asked you to give you an update, please update that, and just make sure any other security software is up to date as well. So those are the hints and tips that I'd like to give you today. Please go on to Get Safe Online, click Before You Call, which is West Yorkshire Police external site, again gives you hints and tips, and then also look at cert.gov.uk. And for businesses wanting to have more up-to-date information on cybersecurity from a business point of view, I would ask them to look at the CISP platform. All these details are on the West Yorkshire Police Cybercrime website and also the Yorkshire and Humber Cybercrime website. So I would say good afternoon and Merry Christmas. Thank you.